My question is regarding school busing. I think we've seen a number of studies that show that childhood development requires some good amounts of sleep. It also affects performance of our students. We also see so many schools saying that they have difficulty finding staff for busing, finding the resources that they need for busing. So my question is, what are you seeing in the data, and is there something more that we can be doing, not just to encourage having more resources there, but also maybe to have our schools act proactively to make sure that our kids aren't doing the 5 in the morning slog that might affect their development? So that's my question. Mm-hmm.
Thank you so much for your question. I'm seeing this as two sides. I'm seeing this as a school sleep, a school sleep study piece, as well as the transportation piece and the shortage of drivers. Again, with the driver piece and the recruitment and retention, districts have been trying tremendously hard to try to get professionals coming out of other careers as truck drivers and bus drivers in the commercial world to move over. So I know that districts are doing a lot of work there, and it's a local phenomenon. Now, in regards to school start times or healthy start times, that's a local decision. I was a leader in my most recent life as superintendent, where the community was very passionate around healthy start times, something they have been working on for 20 years. And to my knowledge, as of last week, perhaps in a school board meeting, now it's going into effect that they are putting together healthy start times in this district for future years. Next year, I believe, would be the start date. So it's a local decision. The only, and I studied this extensively from my last position, the only state that I know of that has made it a statewide rule is California. It actually is not, it's not the entire state of California. It's San Francisco, California, because they don't have transportation. So they moved the start times, and it was all based on the healthy start time data about student sleep patterns.
Yeah, so I think we all know that healthy start times are important, and I know that our local school boards are wrestling with these issues, and I hope that there's something we could do at the statewide level to make those decisions easier for them. I think the questions of how early the start times are raise a whole number host of issues, but that's something that we might be able to control and be able to help the localities with by helping them with funding for those issues. So, thank you.
Thank you, Representative. May I add 10 seconds? Thank you, Chairman. I misconstrued that. It's not simply San Francisco. The legislation began in San Francisco. It is the state of California with the healthy start times.
Thank you.
Thank you.